students, today we'll finish exercise 6.5. So there were two sums left, question number 7 and question number 8. Okay, so now question number 7 is saying, find the perimeter of a rectangle. Find the perimeter of a rectangle. So we have to draw this rectangle. So this is a rectangle. Okay. Find the perimeter of a rectangle whose length is given 40 centimeter and the diagonal is given 41 centimeter. Diagonal means this one. Diagonal is given 41 centimeter. Okay. Now you have to find the perimeter. So to find the perimeter, you need the value of length as well as breadth. So we don't know what this is, isn't it? We don't know breadth, but when we are drawing this diagonal, we can observe that we are getting this particular right angle triangle, isn't it? So by using Pythagoras theorem, you can easily find this. So this is a hypotenuse, because opposite to 90 degree, the side which is opposite to 90 degree is always hypotenuse. This is base and this is perpendicular. Okay, once you get the value of perpendicular, you get the value of breadth. Okay, so let's do it. So you will write using Pythagoras theorem. Okay, so what is it? 8 squared equals to b squared plus b squared. So h is what? 41 squared. B, you have to find it out. B is what? 40 squared. Okay. Now 441 square is 1681. B square we are not aware of. 40 square is 1600. Now we'll remove this 1600. So what we'll do? We have to subtract 1600 to both the side. Isn't it? So this will be cancelled. So now the answer will be 81 equals to p square. So 9 9 is 81. So p value is 9. Okay. So now, since we know the length value is what? 40 centimeter. Breadth is 9 centimeter. So perimeter would be, perimeter formula is 2 length plus breadth. We have already studied this. So 2 in place of length we'll put 40, in place of breadth we'll put 9. So according to the Bodmer's rule, we have to solve the bracket first. So 40 plus 9 is 49, and now we'll multiply it. So 2 9s are 18, 2 are 8 and 98 centimeter. So the perimeter of a rectangle is 98 centimeter. Okay. So this is the solution of question number 7. So let's move on to question number 8. Now in question number 8, the diagonal of a rhombus. Now we have to draw a rhombus first. So what is a rhombus, students? You remember? A rhombus is a figure whose all sides are equal. Okay. Whose all sides are equal. That is, it's sort of a square only. Okay, so this is a rhombus whose all sides are equal. These are the properties of rhombus, you should know. So the diagonals of two diagonals are given according to the question. So before I say something on diagonals, you should know something on diagonals is, see, in rhombus the diagonals are not equal to each other. Okay, but they bisect each other. Okay, suppose this diagonal is 10 centimeter and this diagonal is 12 centimeter. So this part will be 5, this part will be 5, and this, if this whole diagonal is 12, then this part will be 6 and this part will be 6. So they bisect each other. Okay, they divide themselves into two equal halves. This is one property, and when they intersect, they make a 90 degree. Okay, so according to the question, the rhombus, the diagonals measurements are given. Suppose this diagonal, that means this one, okay, is given 16 centimeter. according to the question. And this diagonal is given 30 centimeters. Okay, so this is 30, this is 16. So as because the diagonals bisect each other, so what is the half of 16? 8. So this would be 8. This will be also 8. So 8 plus 8, 16. Now this whole, the measurement of whole diagonals is what? 30. So what is the half of 30? 15. So this part would be 15 and this part would be 15. Isn't it? Now they have asked find the perimeter. To find the perimeter, you have to know the measurement of the side. So if you know the measurement of one side, then you will know the measurement of all the sides because all the sides are equal, isn't it? So this is a triangle, you see. This is a right angle triangle, isn't it? So in right angle triangle, opposite to 90 degrees is what? Hypotenuse. So if you get the value of hypotenuse, that will be equal to the measurement of a side of a rhombus. So if you find this particular side, then you can get the perimeter of the rhombus, isn't it? So how to get it? Again, we'll use Pythagoras theorem, because you see, this is a right angle triangle. Opposite to 90 degrees is what? Hypotenuse. This is base and this is perpendicular, isn't it? So you write using Pythagoras theorem. You write the theorem a squared equals to p squared plus b squared. So according to this particular triangle, we do not know the value of hypotenuse. I'm repeatedly saying that a side which is opposite to, the side which is opposite to 90 degrees is hypotenuse. So value of hypotenuse is unknown, base is given and perpendicular is given. So perpendicular is given 8 square and this is given 15 square. So let's get the value. 8 square is 64 and this is 225. So it will be 289. Okay. So the 289 is 17 square. 17 into 17 is 289. Okay, students. So H is 17 centimeters. So now we know the value of H. So H is equals to side of a rhombus, isn't it? That is equals to 17 centimeter. Now what will be the perimeter? Perimeter means sum of all the sides, isn't it? So if this is 17 meter, this will be also 17, this will be also 17, this will be also 17, because all the sides of a rhombus are equal. So now we'll get the value of perimeter. So perimeter of a rhombus is equals to 4 into side, which is very similar to square, isn't it? So what is the measurement of side? 17. So this will be 68 centimeters. Okay, so this is the solution of question number 8. Okay, so today's assignment is just two sum, question number 7 and question number 8. Okay, thank you and take care.